Hello everyone. Donna Gray here, your independent stamping up demonstrator from the Northern Rivers area in New South Wales, Australia, bringing you another project today which is really, really beautiful. I thought instead of doing a card for a change, I might do a gift box. I seen this on a video and I thought, oh my God, it's a must have, especially with our Star of Light bundle set, because it is such a beautiful set. You can do so many nice things with it. So what I thought I'd do today is show you how I created this beautiful little box with a lid, and it's a really good big decent size as well. So to do it, I thought I'll do it in a different color so you can see what it looks like in a couple of different colors. Okay, so today what I'm going to do, I'll show you what we're going to use. We're actually going to be using the Star of Light bundle set, which comes out of our annual catalog, holiday catalog, that's available at the moment from the 1st of September until the 3rd of January. The Star of Light set is a beautiful set. You may have watched my other YouTube video of my beautiful cherry cobbler Christmas card using this. Ever since I've got this set, I can't put it down. It's absolutely stunning. Some of the framelits that come in the bundle up in here, the stars, the snowflakes, absolutely gorgeous. And this beautiful glittery spray of stars and glitter is just gorgeous. It finishes off a lot of things. So this comes in a bundle, worthwhile getting the bundle to be able to cut out some stars and things, and also stamps. Lots of beautiful sayings as well. Okay, so that's on page 9 of our holiday catalog. If you don't have a holiday catalog and you live in Australia and you would like me to send you out one, please message me at the end of this video and I'll be happy to send one out to you. Okay, so what we're actually going to use today is I'll pop that up in the corner there. We're going to be using some cherry cobbler cardstock. I thought I'll do a nice cherry cobbler one. I did Knight of Navy here and I thought I'll do cherry cobbler for the next one. Okay, so to start off with, we need 2 pieces of 8¾ inch by 6 inch cherry cobbler cardstock. And we also need another 5⅞ inch square piece, and that's for our lid. So that's all it takes, is that couple of scrap pieces to be able to make our snowflake star, our little tiny, we'll do that as a cherry cobbler, we did it in Knight of Navy, and some little scrap pieces just for our little sentiment, and some nice little rhinestones to pop around the place to make it look really nice. Okay, so we also will be needing Versamark ink pad and some gold embossing powder we'll be needing. You'll need some Stampin' Up! Dimensionals. The stamp that we'll be using is, as you can see, mine has been used and I've only had it for 3 weeks, been used quite a bit. The nice beautiful spray in the stamp set, the Star of Light stamp set, this one here. And I'm also going to use the sentiment Merry Christmas out of this one as well. And just a quick look at the starlet thinlets that you get, Star of Light thinlets. Okay, so you get beautiful snowflakes, nice big star to cut out. We'll be using this die here to cut out our shapes out of the sides of our gift box and the top. We've got a nice big snowflake that we did for the big snowflake, little snowflake for the little embellishment on top. And we've used some of these stars as well. So I'll get them out, pop them out, ready to use. Okay, so let's get started. What we've actually got to do is we've got to score some things to start off with. So with our box sides, so we're going to need your score pal. And we're going to grab my bone folder. Okay, so along the 8¾ inch side, we're going to score at 4¼ and 8½. And then we're going to turn it around and we're going to score it at 2¾. Okay, so we're going to do the same with our other piece. So we're going to score it at 4¼, 8.5. Turn around to the 6-inch length here, and we're going to score at 2.75. Okay. So what you'll find is you'll have a bigger side here, smaller side, and a narrow piece on both. Okay, we'll score the lid while we're going. 3/4 of an inch we need to score all the way around. So that's one side, 3/4 of an inch, next side, 3/4 of an inch, next side, 3/4 of an inch. Okay, so that's our lid scored. Okay, so that's all we need to do with our scoring pal. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to bring the big shot in, and we're going to, sorry, before we do that, with our two side pieces, what we need to do is the narrow part, that's the bottom of our box. These are the sides. So as you'll see, this is a narrower part than that part there. Okay, so what we're going to do is save confusion. We're going to cut up the score line in the middle there on the narrow part. And now this little narrow part, we're actually going to cut that little tiny section up to this middle score line and take that section away. Okay, so we're going to do that on both of our pieces. So still the narrow part to the bottom again. So we're going to cut straight up in that middle score line. And we're going to cut that little narrow piece off. Okay. Now, also with our lid, before we go any further, we'll work that one out. We're going to make some little tabs. So we're going to go straight up. You'll see you'll have a little box on each corner. We're going to go straight up on that side, and we're going to cut a little notch out. Turn it around, we're going to go straight up again and cut a little notch out. Okay, make sure you leave one side with two straight edges that you, okay, so you cut up the score line again, straight up the score line, and on this piece here, we cut the little notch out. Turn it around, straight up the score line, and cut the little notch out. Okay, so that's got our lid ready as well. So now what we're going to do is do a bit of cutting with our Big Shot. So I'll just grab the Big Shot machine. Now, I'm using my magnetic platform for this because it's easier with these little pieces to have it on the magnetic platform. Actually, what I might do is turn my whole machine around. Okay. Now, what we're going to do is with our side pieces again, this is the part that we're going to cut our shape out in. So, we're going to take this framelit, and you'll find that what actually happens is it's got a longer piece. That longer piece we're going to put towards the bottom of our box, and we're going to center it in the middle. Also going to center some little stars. Put our top plate on. Sometimes the magnets want to move little tiny framelits, so just be careful when you go to do that, that doesn't move, and run it through the machine. Okay. And what you'll find is you get beautiful cut out piece and your little stars cut out. Okay, to save a bit of time, I'm now going to do that on all four of those panels. So I've got another three to go, and I'll be right back with you. Okay, so these are our two pieces that we've cut out. Okay, so our two sides of our boxes. It's going to actually go that way. Okay, so that's the bottom of our box along here. Okay, so now also with our top piece, I'm going to get the Big Shot again, our lid. We're going to run them through the Big Shot as well to cut them out. Okay, so we're going to place our lid on. And I'm going to place that in the middle. And a couple of stars around. Helps if you put it up the right way. And pop our top plate on and run that through. Sometimes with these detailed thinlets, I actually like to run them through a second time just to make sure we get all the little pieces cut out. Okay, now as you can see, a lot of pieces stay in our little die. And Stampin' Up! Has a beautiful little brush set that helps you get things out. In your cardstock, if you haven't seen this, it's a fantastic little tool. You can run it over, see how the bits just pop out, okay? And save you having to fiddle around trying to get all those little pieces out. Okay, same with your dies. You turn your dies down that way, and you'll see that they all pop out of your die as well. Okay, great natty little invention, the little die brush. Okay, so if you haven't got that, if you get detailed thinlets, it is an absolute must. Okay, so before we start to stick these together, we're going to do a bit of embossing now with some gold embossing powder to create a bit of a pattern on the edges of our box. So I'm going to bring in a little bit of scratch paper so I don't end up with Versamark everywhere. Okay, so for the first side, what I thought I would do is just along these big edges that we have here, I thought we can do the nice sparkly spray with our Versamark. Okay, so in case you have never embossed before, our little embossing buddy is an awesome little thing. It's a little pillow with some powder, and it stops our embossing powder from sticking to things that we don't actually want it to stick to, because sometimes we have oil on our fingers that can get on our cardstock, and you'll find that your embossing powder will then stick to the where your oily fingerprints have been. We don't want that to happen. Okay, so ink it up with the Versamark ink pad, and we're going to do a nice spray down through. I might do it a little bit different to the other one. I might go further down. This is where you can really play around with things. The first one I did, I thought, oh, that's nice. But then I thought, oh, it could have came down further. It would have looked nicer. Okay, so on our next side piece, I'm going to do the same thing. So I'm going to ink up with Versamark again. Ink it up really well. My poor Versamark's getting a little bit dry. I need to re-ink it. Okay, I'm going to go down a fair bit through there. Okay, so now that we've got those two stamped, we bring in our gold embossing powder, sprinkle it over, and you'll find when you give it a bit of a tap, you'll see that the powder has stuck to our image. Do it to the next one. Okay, powder has stuck to our image. Okay, we'll pop that back in our container. Okay, now I'm going to bring in the heat tool. Hit that with a bit of heat. Sorry about the noise. I like to heat it up a fair bit first before I put it on my cardstock, as it saves the cardstock from warping too much. Okay, now as you'll see, when it starts getting hot enough that it will melt the powder, the gold appears. Like magic. And as you can see, This is a beautiful, beautiful image. This sparkly stars. Absolutely gorgeous. We'll do it on the other one. Now, when you're embossing, you'll find the embossing powder goes a little bit bubbly at first, and then the more you heat it, it then starts to go really nice and smooth. When it's got that nice smooth texture, you know you've actually heated it enough. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're actually going to stick our two sides together. So we're going to burnish our folds. Just be careful of where you've embossed when you're burnishing your folds, as you don't want to ruin the embossing that we've just done. Okay. So what I tend to do is just go around the embossing. I just find it easier to emboss when it is actually flat. Sometimes when you've burnished your folds, it makes it harder to get a really nice clear image. But as you'll see, we have to do that anyway in a minute, because once we attach these two sides, then we have to do a bit more embossing. Okay, so now on this little tab that we have here, okay, we're just going to run some of our tear and tape along that tab and along the tab on the other side. Need something fairly strong. The tear and tape is quite strong enough to hold the box together, because this is our side seam, so we need it to hold together quite well. Okay, little tip, if you burnish your tear and tape, it's easier to get that back off. Hopefully it's not going to make a liar out of me. You can get your pokey tool underneath and straight off it comes. Okay, pokey tool underneath the backing and straight off. Okay, so if you've ever had hassles with tear and tape, that's a nice little handy hint. Okay, line them up there. Then with this one, we fold that over and fold that over. There you go. Okay, so now what we're going to do is we're going to stamp some images. Down through these bits here, that bit there and that bit there. Okay, so we're going to ink up our lovely spray of sparkle again with our Versamark. Sorry, embossing buddy first. Okay, we'll do one side at a time. Okay, this time I might go, yes, we might go right down in there again. Okay, gold embossing powder, sprinkle it over. Okay, pop the embossing powder back in. Heat tool again, sorry for the noise. And there's the magic again. When you get to know me, you'll realize I absolutely love embossing. Probably one of my most favorite things with stamping is embossing the image. Okay, wait for that to cool a little bit. Cool to touch, yep. Okay, embossing buddy again. Here, ink up our image again, and stamp. always like to hold it down for a little while too to make sure that the ink goes on our cardstock quite well. Bit of gold embossing powder again. Okay, clean that up. Heat gun again. Okay, so that's very nice. That's the bottom of our box. As you can see, two fold in. Voila, there's our box. Okay, so to assemble the bottom, all I do is on these two flaps, because we're only having two flaps that are going to go over, put some tear and tape on those. Always like about three strips to make sure that you get a really good firm base. Once again, burnish your tear and tape. Make it easier to get the pieces off the back. Sorry, I'll get rid of that. Back onto a clean surface again. Okay, same thing again with your pokey tool, underneath the backing, and up it comes. Makes life much easier, I can tell you, if you burnish that tape first. Okay, so we've got one side ready. Now, make sure you line your box up really nice and square, okay, before you pop that down. Okay, turn it over, press inside. Okay, that's one side. Take off the backing paper. Okay, square it up again, nice and neat. And press it down. That's the bottom of our box. Okay, now, that's as easy as it is. Very good size box, this too. Okay, now we're going to do our lid. So we're going to bring in our scratch paper again. We're going to do some more embossing. Okay, same sparkly stamp. We're going to ink it up with our Versamark again. Okay, now what I did with this, I actually just went sideways across it because I really wanted it to be all over that top section and coming down on the sides of our box as well. So stamp it that side. Okay, ink it up again. And I forgot my embossing buddy. I might actually just do it, pop it there. See now I've remembered that part. Always a good habit to get into. I just getting a bit carried away with the video and forgot to do it. And stamp it there. Okay. Gold embossing powder again. Sprinkle it over. Tap it off. Pop the excess back in. Always remember too to pop your lid on your embossing powder and your Versamark so it doesn't dry out too much. Okay, heat gun again. Now don't panic, as you can see my card started to warp a little bit. I can tell you, stamping up cardstock is awesome. It doesn't take long for it to go back down flat again. Once it cools, it flattens straight back out. Some cardstocks don't. Some cardstocks, when you heat them, they warp, and it's very hard to get them to look nice and smooth and flat again. I can tell you, stamping up cardstock, you will not have that problem. And there we are, nicely embossed on top. Okay, while we're doing the embossing, I might grab my little scrap piece of cherry cobbler that I have. And I've got my Merry Christmas out of the stamp set, this little one here. We'll ink that up with some Versamark. Whoops. And embossing buddy again. Okay, stamp it down. And up. Bit of gold embossing powder. Pop the excess back in again. Heat gun. My sentiment done. Pop all my embossing gear out of the way now because I'm finished that. Okay, now with our lid, pretty basic. We have our little flaps, so what we're going to do is put some tear and tape on those little bits where we notched in. Those are little tabs that are just going to fold inside to make our lid. As I said, make sure you burnish your little bits of tear and tape. Make it easy to get those backs off. All that does is it sticks it to the cardstock. And make sure that you've got a good stick that it doesn't try and lift up off the cardstock when you go to pull the backing paper off. Sometimes if it's not stuck to your cardstock real well, it will actually tend to try and lift up with the backing paper. Okay, so I'm just going to take those two off first. Okay. Slack of me, I forgot to burnish those edges. Folds. Just watch your embossing again as you burnish that you don't disturb it. Okay, so what you do is these little tabs are going to fold in, and what you do is you line your corners up really, really well and get a really good strong corner. Same thing on this side. Line it up really well. Okay. Take the backing off that. Same thing again on this side. Fold it in, get a really nice corner, and same thing with this one, fold it in, nice corner. And there you are, you have your lid for your box. Okay, and it pops on quite nicely. Okay, so now we've only got to do finishing touches, and our project is just about finished. So now I cut ahead of time, I cut my gold snowflake, my cherry cobbler snowflake. So what I actually did on my other one, I used a stamping up dimensional to pop it up on, which I've lost my dimensionals at the moment. I'll be back in a tick. They were just sitting underneath my catalogue. Okay, so I'm going to pop a dimensional on the back, right in the middle of my star, of my snowflake. Okay, take the back off. And then I'm going to place it. I actually might place it over the other side and have it going the other side this time. Right there. Okay, so now with a glue dot, I pop a glue dot on the back of my cherry cobbler snowflake. Like so. Still make sure I have the long point down. Remember that there is a long and a short point to these snowflakes. Okay, now just gonna pop a rhinestone in the middle of that. Like so. Okay, now with our Merry Christmas that we had, our sentiment, what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut it with a bit of a tail coming out. And I might cut this side like that too. Okay, and with a little bit of gold foil card, going to run a strip of tear and tape on the back, burnish it. Okay, I'm going to stick it up in the corner here. Now, very easy to do this. You just create a little border around your sentiment, and it just finishes it off. Little bit of gold border. Okay, now with my dimensionals again. Sorry, I'm actually going to, with my bone folder, curl it a little bit and curl the end up a little bit. And the end up a little bit like that. Just a little hint, it makes your sentiment look really, really nice. Okay, so we're going to put Stampin' Up! Dimensional on the back there and the back there. Take it off. Take the backing off. And we might pop it just underneath and across there. Okay, so there you have it. I actually finished my other one off with a few more rhinestones and things, which you can do. It's up to you how you want to embellish them. But lovely, lovely gift box set. Okay. Absolutely beautiful idea. And you can pop some nice little treats, Christmas baking, absolutely anything of your choice. Okay, I hope you like the video. I will leave a link to my online store and the item numbers of the products that I've used in this video. Please feel free to jump online and browse in my store. At the moment, there's some sales on in September. If you get onto my online store, you can see the September sales. They will pop up on the website. Feel free to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already subscribed to my channel. And please give me the thumbs up and like this video, as it helps me in other people viewing my video if you give me the thumbs up. Okay, I hope you like this video, and hopefully I can get to do maybe another one this week sometime. So this is the beautiful Star of Light bundle. As I said, you can I'll post the link down in the information box down below. Please leave me a message if there's anything you'd like to ask, any questions you'd like to ask about doing this project or any other project. Please leave me a message in the comments and I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Thank you for watching. See you again next video. Thanks.